In this video, I am going to discuss two interesting topics. Now, at the instance of MCA, all ROC office across India has given extension of time for convening the AGM in the year 2020 up to 31st December 2020. What will happen if the gap between two AGM exceeds 15 months? Will it be treated as contravention of Section 96 of the Companies Act 2013? This is the main question arises. I am going to explain this. As per Section 96, every company other than OPC is required to hold an AGM every year. AGM should be held on the earliest of the following dates: 15 months from the date of the last AGM. So there should not be gap between two AGM 15 months. Then the last day of the calendar year, that 31st December, or 6 months from the close of the financial year. In the event of any difficulty in holding an AGM, the ROC may grant an extension of time for any special reason by 3 months. In such situation, if company does not hold the AGM in a particular year, it will not be treated as that the company has contravened the Section 96. Now that the ROC is given a blanket extension for holding the AGMs until 31st December 2020, the issue of gap between two AGMs arises. Supposing a company has held its AGM in July 2019, last year, the gap of 15 months would come into effect and the company would not be able to take full benefit under the circular. However, when this relaxation is given by the government and the respective ROCs, keeping in mind the unprecedented situation, COVID-19 situation caused due to this pandemic, and if there is a considerable amount of gap of more than 15 months between two AGM, the same will not be considered as a non-compliance. Hence, one can take benefit of the circular issued by all ROCs across India, as the process of making an application in e-form GNL is also dispensed with. However, the details of the circular issued by the respective ROC has to be specified in the notice calling AGM. The next topic is 5% tax at source on foreign remittance starting from 1st October 2020. This is also an important topic. Those making foreign remittance need to pay attention to the tax collected at source TCS liability from the next month, as a key tax provision kicks in from 1st October 2020. As per the Finance Act 2020, funds sent abroad under the RBI liberalized scheme, LRS scheme, is subject to a 5% TCS subject to riders. Authorized dealer receiving an amount of or an aggregate of amount of rupees 7 lakhs or more in a financial year for remittance out of India under the LRS of RBI shall be liable to collect TCS if he receives a sum in excess of said amount from a buyer, being a person remitting such amount out of India at the rate of 5%. So this is coming into effect 1st October 2020. Friends, thanking you for watching this video. And if you like this video, I request you to subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, RV Shekhar, Practicing Company Secretary.